So I was just playing my game, enjoying Injustice 2, playing it so much, you know. But I was feeling tired playing the game, you know. So I just want to go to a grocery store, and I just wanted something. I just wanted something. Anyways, I left for a bit, and guess what I saw? I saw this random guy come up to me. This random dude. I never seen him in my life. He comes up to me and says these types of words to me. I just didn't understand.
So he said to me,
"Hey, you, I seen you before. I watch your videos. Yay, you."
So this crazy dude was basically just yelling at me and stuff. Like, he was so excited, but I told him to chill out, and then he says this,
"Oh my god, Jeffrey, you're such a stupid..."
So the only thing I did after he said that to me is that I made his brain explode.
Hello everybody, welcome to the first video of drama. Today I'll be discussing about David, who is a troll on the internet, who has been spreading red pill all over the place, and about, you know, Sneeko, Andrew Tate, you know, those guys. Today I'll be discussing about his harassment against me. His videos are really on not understanding any of his videos, because let's be honest here, he's just copy and pasting of other videos of documentaries. But since I want to talk about him, I want to talk about stuff that he had done in previous times before the video started. He has been showing a lot of aggression against me. It seems like he's been attacking me for my videos or my old content that he wants. But instead of in the way of arguing about my videos' flaws of previous ones, he instead attacked me by racial stuff and other things.
I want to begin in my story, in my perspective of this guy. This guy came along around my series when it came out, and we partnered up for a little bit, you know? But he seems like when we were partnering up, he didn't really care about where I was put in. You know, I was in his reaction channel, the recent one that was deleted. He tried to do stuff for me, but it always ends up badly. Sometimes I want to say that this guy's been acting like he's a red pill Sneeko clone. You know, he hasn't tried so much of things that didn't match up with his channel. Like, he doesn't understand Sneeko. He doesn't understand any of these people he brings up in these videos when he makes them. Rather, he thinks that Andrew Tate would be some, he thinks he's a god or someone that, like, you know. In his perspective of the video, he puts out Andrew's, you know, he showed the internet, he showed this, he showed that, but, like, you have to understand, like, you're making this video about him, like, who is this for, you know? And I'm assuming that he really doesn't understand Andrew Tate or Sneeko, because as of right now, Sneeko is really trying to battle people. He recently did a Nazi stuff on live stream. And it's very confusing because this guy, David, I'm going to call him David because that's how I met him, because he is not understanding nothing about this YouTube stuff. It seems like he's abusing a lot of stuff in these channels. I have been notified about his Discord, and let's say that he is not a good person to be on Discord. He thinks that he can say whatever he wants with no consequence. He talks about a lot of people. He calls me a lot of things that are very offensive. And he stays back a lot of those things. He, you know, he doesn't like to explain himself why he says those things. It's just those are really complicated things about this man. I mean, he has said these things on Discord attacking me and accusing me of things, and it's unbelievable. Unbelievable it is.
As of now, his new videos are not really motivated in some way. You can see that he takes a lot of screenshots, recordings. He tries to hide a lot of information. He is missing a lot of the gaps. What he's doing in the documentary, he doesn't focus a lot of things. He doesn't look at them. But those are the key opponents of these characters. More like when he did the Sneeko video, he was missing a lot about his girlfriend issues and stuff like that. He forgets the Sneeko getting cucked. He forgets that. He tries to hide everything that makes the Sneeko look bad and make him look good instead. And hiding the information like that are not really... let's say, in a case, in my word, doesn't really know, like, that. Those are the events that happen. You know, there's other things like, for example, Chris Chan, when he was harassed on the internet, he knew that it was a bad idea to put out the information of his address, so he is doing that because it was didn't work out well, and it made it more trolls. That's part of like the history of the attacks. But in these documents, going back to David, these documents are not really, you know, documented in a way. He puts it. He takes away a lot of stuff. He takes away the videos out of context. More like he is, you know, making them look like it's a good thing for, you know, attacking these people. Sneeko's argument was good. Most of Sneeko's arguments are just yelling and screaming, thinking that he's better than everyone, making the other opponent not talk, making him act like he's the winner, which is not the point of Sneeko. Sneeko's way of arguing somebody is either behind a camera, make a video, do a live stream, and then attack someone on Twitter, which is basically everybody who does that. Any person who got big fame and, you know, acts like a red pill are those people. And David seems like he doesn't understand nothing at all. He doesn't know anything about these characters. These, I would say, YouTubers. I would say not anymore, but in this video, I'll be talking about that. And it just doesn't work out well. It just doesn't work out. He attacks me because of my skin color. He attacks me for things that are really... I don't know. It's just to get under my skin. But I tried trying to give him context, and he just doesn't let me. He doesn't put context. He situates the idea all the way up. All the way up. He makes the situation way worse than it was before. It was just like, it could be like, I could be talking about pizza, and then if he gets so mad about pizza because it killed him, I don't know. It's just those points are just really insane for his, you know, his point of view. It's just not really himself. More like he's taking everything in context, out of context, and make him like, you know, so this, oh, Andrew T was my hero because he spread out the hate and toxicity. Toxicity was so good. No, it's not. Look what happened to most of the YouTubers that end up being toxic. EDP and other YouTubers. Hell, even the most offensive was Gypsy Crusader behind cameras, and no one knew about him. He got arrested for it. Hey. You're taking things from everything, and it just doesn't add up. You don't add up a lot of things. But seeing how this is getting complicated over and over again about things that he does, it just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. I mean, let's be honest, Jaylen, on the other hand, is still on YouTube, and she's been attacking, well, not exactly attacking, more like doing something on Twitter, which is a way to get a response. But seeing how David, the guy who was harassing me, just doesn't understand the idea of what makes these people, you know, red pill and stuff. He seems to overestimate a lot of people that are either they try putting content out and it was made of love in some cases, but it seems like he doesn't show his face. He doesn't understand his point of view. Most of the views he puts on is just a mask that he is hiding behind doors of the computer screen. But he doesn't know his real self. That's the problem here. The real David is insane, I want to say. I want to say he is not the person to be around with or friends with in some cases like these. Because a YouTuber has to represent themselves in some cases like that. And these screenshots don't really prove anything that he's worthy to be in the platform if he's going to be putting out things like that. So far, it's just that hasn't been that great for his channel. Sure, he has reacted to some good content once in a while, like the FNAF video. But everything else he has done is just not good. I mean, yes, you can put memes, that's fine. He has a lot of misspelling, but, you know, how many people has misspelled in the world, you know? 7K shorts, he does really well on, but it's just not a way to, like, grow more. You have to keep putting out more shorts, like I did, you know? He isn't bright. I want to say he isn't bright because pretty soon in the future, this might backstab him up the ass. And I'm sorry to say this, but he is literally someone that will not give up until he is exposed. And this time, I will be exposing him for these things. Soon, I would like everyone to know that not to harass him in some cases. Don't be someone, just don't go up to his channel, don't subscribe to him, don't like anything that he does. Just, in this case, probably report his channel or his TikTok, which is a good way to help me out with the situation. So, I would like to say that it would be a great way to stop this man from, you know, attacking my channel. So, but my story doesn't end here because as of now, as a YouTuber, I have to be aware of this guy coming to my channel. You know, is he really gonna be that person to attack me? Is he gonna bring his fans? Should I be prepared in case those happen? Well, it doesn't need, I need to get prepared because as you guys know, I love you guys as much as possible. I know the series has been backed up a lot. I have been sadly been doing other things. I was in my college, but seeing how my channel has been evolved currently with my YouTube shorts, I want to thank everyone who is supporting me. But here's one problem. None of you guys are subscribed to my channel, which is pretty sad, that I want my channel to grow more and more better than this guy I talked to online, you know, the guy who's harassing me. It's gonna be a good point in the video where I'm gonna celebrate if we're gonna do something about this guy. We have to stop this guy. He is attacking me, he's harassing me all the time, and this is not the type of behavior you should do on the internet. And you'd think that he would get away. He has been on TikTok harassing other people. He's been harassing a lot of people for their own content. And I think that this man, or this boy, I would say, because he more acts like a child on his videos than a man. Currently, right now, he's on a Spanish channel, and right now, we could do something about this. One, we could try age restricting him in some case, because currently some of his live streams were really offensive, and as a person that I saw them were either not, there was no harm in some cases, but in the live stream, but he did put the title, obvious title, that what he said was something else to get the attention. He's an attention seeker, so I'm gonna just only do one video or two, and you know, we'll see how it goes, you know. But anyways, guys, I would like to thank everyone that supported me so far and on YouTube. So if you guys can subscribe, like, and share, that would be great. And I'll see you guys next time.
that you can play. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. LA, you can get a take. Miami, you can get a take.